Hi, I'm Susan Arndt, and this is the video supplement for my 5 favorite games of 2009. Number 5 on my list is PopCap's take on tower defense, Plants vs. Zombies. Now, I don't normally like tower defense games because I'm really bad at strategy, but I've lost track of how many times I've beaten this game, and I still have a really good time every time I fire it up. It's really easy to learn, incredibly addictive, and has a fantastic sense of humor. From the notes the zombies leave in between levels, to their descriptions in your journal, to just the general concept. I mean, seriously, pea shooters to defend yourself against zombies? That's pretty funny. Number 4 on my list is Emerald City Confidential, which frankly, should suck. It's a noir mystery set in the Land of Oz. You know, the one with Dorothy, the Tin Man, and the Cowardly Lion? That shouldn't work. But it does really, really well, because the writing is fantastic, and the voice acting is pretty darn good, too. The story is absolutely amazing, taking the gritty noir and blending it really, really well with the whimsical setting, so that it's never too depressing or too silly. It's not the hardest adventure game you're ever going to play, but it's absolutely one of the best.
Or I charge you for my time.
Number 3 on my list is The Path. Now, I'll be honest, I had a lot more fun with other games this year, but I didn't have many experiences that were more memorable than my time with The Path, which is kind of a retelling of Little Red Riding Hood. It's weird, and the only way you can win is to lose, but it's definitely an experience unlike anything else. It leaves a lot of the game up to your interpretation, which means that your version of The Path is going to be completely different from mine and everybody else's. How often can you say something like that? Number 2 on my list is Uncharted 2 Among Thieves. Now, I've heard all sorts of things about, ooh, Nate Drake is a bad guy because he goes around shooting people and he's robbing things. You know, I don't care. I don't care. I think he's awesome. I love hanging out with him. I think Chloe is cool. They're great people. I feel like I've been dropped into the middle of a movie like Romancing the Stone or Indiana Jones or Tomb Raider, if they were any good. It's just a fun romp, and oh my god, have you seen how pretty it is? Seriously, I got shot like 20 times because I was standing there looking at the scenery. True story. And my number 1 favorite game of 2009 is Dragon Age Origins. This is the kind of RPG that you can dive into and not come up for air for hours. Your entire day will go by and you won't even realize it because you're having such a good time. Yeah, the game has some flaws, including the fact that it is god-awful ugly on the Xbox 360, but I don't care because there's just so much cool stuff to do. There's the main story, which I actually care about, unlike some other epic RPGs I could mention. There's all the side quests. There's trying to get my companions to like me. There's gifts. There's... well, I don't want to tell you what there is. You'll just have to find out for yourself. It's an incredibly epic, huge adventure, and I can't wait for the next one. So there you have it. There are my 5 favorite games of 2009. I hope you enjoy them as much as I do. If you don't, you suck. Okay, maybe you don't suck. Maybe just a little. Happy holidays!